Did you know that the saltwater fishing lure industry started right here in Corpus Christi? Well, Chris 6 News anchor Lee Sosley recently sat down with a local collector to learn more about the sparkling City by the Sea's legacy of lures.
Fishing hats.
Dr. David McKee recently retired after a 30-year career as a marine biology professor at Texas A&amp Corpus Christi. He's an avid fisherman and a passionate collector of old fishing tackle, artificial lures in particular. It's a passion that dates back to his boyhood in Sinton, Texas.
I've still got lures that I had when I was a teenager. I loved fishing lures. I took very good care of them. I polished them and just started adding to my collection.
And today that collection numbers in the thousands, and the vast majority of these lures were made by companies right here in Corpus Christi.
I am a bit of a historian, and I think my interest in the lures has a lot to do with the history of our area.
Dr. McKee says Corpus Christi really played a big role in promoting the use of artificial lures for saltwater fishing. In fact, there were as many as seven different lure companies here in the late 20s and early 30s.
Several of the manufacturers that went on to produce plastic baits when plastic became available after World War II started out by carving their lures at night out of pieces of wood. Cedar was kind of a preferred wood to work with.
And several of those companies went on to become national brands.
One of them was Fred Nichols, who had the Fred Nichols lure company that later on became PICO, P-I-C-O, Padre Island Company, which became a flourishing company around the country, both coasts.
Plugging Shorty was a well-known lure maker here. His real name was Anton Stettner. He was a Fuller brush salesman who visited here and liked it so much he moved down here. Back then, fish was 3 cents a pound, and he made a good living with a rod and reel and his own handmade fishing lures.
And he was making these, his lures, and using them made from cedar. And there were no colors available at that time. You had a brown lure, and maybe you could put a little glitter on it, or maybe put a little red fingernail polish on it, but he made his living fishing with his own lures.
Later on, when plastics and colors became available, he teamed up with Doug English, who started the Bingo Bait Company. But Dr. McKee says that took some convincing.
His first response was, "I will not do it, because if there were more of my lures available to people, they would be catching more fish, and the price of fish would be driven down below 3 cents a pound." After he thought about the money he could make, he changed his mind.
Dr. McKee says he plans to donate his collection to the Museum of Science and History, but not just yet. He's still having too much fun with it. I'm Lee Sosley, Chris 6 News.